I made all of these texture maps from just a single image. And in this video, I'm going to show you how exactly you can do it for free using ChatGPT. Before diving in, if you're someone who is just getting started with Blender, 3D design, or game development, you have probably heard about PBR textures. PBR stands for physically based rendering. It's basically a way to make a 3D model look more real by showcasing how surfaces react to light, shadows, and reflections. For this method, there are a few important types of maps that we'll need to work with. So this is a normal map which adds small surface details without making your model heavier. And then this is a roughness map to control how shiny or rough a surface looks. Then we have a metallic map to define what part of the model should look like a metal. Then we have height maps to create depth and bumps. And then finally, last but not the least, we have ambient occlusion to add soft shadows in the corners and small cracks. But here's the thing, buying good quality textures can get expensive real quick. And if you're someone who is just starting out, paying for a monthly texture subscription might not be an ideal deal for you. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can generate your own texture maps for free using ChatGPT. And the sponsor of today's video is me. Because for you guys, I have made a tool by using which you can generate your texture maps within just few clicks. More on that later on this video. And stay till the end because I'll be doing a giveaway also. So that's being said, there'll be time codes throughout this video so that you can skip and watch the part that might help you the most. So yes, let's get started. So from here, you can see that I'm on my free subscription plan. Here you can see this is my current plan. And this is the prompt that I have used to generate the ambient occlusion, height, normal map, roughness. And there is another one for roughness because in the free one, there is a limit to it. So I had to try multiple times. And yeah, and don't worry, you will get the prompts from the description. Here are the outputs, because here you can see that it's not directly generating an image. It's basically processing that image and converting it into a height map or ambient occlusion or normal map. So you can just directly download it from here. And it has provided this file because of this part of this prompt that I have written that you should deliver a downloadable PNG file. So yeah, here's the prompt you can see. This was our base image. This is the normal that we got from the free version. This is the ambient occlusion. This is the metallic map, and this is the height map, and this is the roughness map. So yeah, this is pretty much straightforward. And if I just do a small breakdown, here you can see that this is also an AI generated image. So I have just written down what I want. And here you can see that I have specified that I want a normal map, but then I describe how the normal map will look. Here you can see that it says RGB color coded evolution XYZ if the texture stylized for 3D rendering purpose. It's like just elaborating the prompt so that it understands better. And lastly, I have added a specific line. Here you can see that it says deliver a downloadable PNG file in 2K resolution or better. This line is important because if you just generate a normal image, it can change the shape or the details. But when you specify that you need a downloadable PNG file, then it will work on the base image and then generate the maps from it. Otherwise, it might change the details or it can hamper the overall texture maps. So yeah, here you can see that the details are consistent. So yeah, these are pretty much straightforward and you can get the prompts from the description. I will also pin it to the first comment so that you can find it easily. So now let's just open Blender. And here I have a basic Blender scene with a camera, sphere, and I have a basic material here. So for this, you will need an add-on, which is Node Wrangler. Let's go to Edit Preferences. And here you can see from the add-on, just search Node Wrangler and enable it. So after enabling the add-on, what I need to do is press principal BSDF, then press Ctrl Shift T. And here what you need to do is you need to rename the images so that the add-on can easily detect each and every one. Then you don't need to plug them in manually. So then let's just press A to select all, then add texture. So here you can see that as we have renamed the images, the add-on has detected the maps and it has plugged them in to the principal BSDF. If we go to the render preview, so here you can see that something is wrong with the roughness. So what we can do is we can add a color ramp here and then we can adjust the values. And now you can see that it's pretty much dark and also not well shaded. Let's enable displacement from here and let's reduce it to 0.05. yeah, and let's scale it up. Okay, let's also reduce the normals to 0.5. I think we can reduce the displacement a little bit here. So yeah, here you can see that from just a single image, we got these PBR textures by only using ChatGPT's free version. If I disconnect all of them, here you can see that this is the base image. If you just use the image, look like this, it doesn't have proper reflection or any details. But with the maps, here you can see that it's pretty much usable. If you tweak the settings, you can adjust it to your scene. But there's a catch to it. If you are using free version of ChatGPT, there are a few obstacles that you need to face. You need to wait for hours and hours to get all of those maps for just a single PBR texture, which might not be worth it. Also, while I was using the free version, I had to wait for hours. Just to show you guys what's the shortcoming of this. So while I was struggling with this, I came up with a tool which will help you to convert your any image into PBR texture. Like it will generate the normal maps, height, roughness, ambient occlusion, and everything. So yeah, let me just quickly show you the tool. This is the tool. If I open it, here you can see that this is a simple UI. This is a pretty much straightforward program, but if you are using it for the first time, you need to verify your purchase. For that, you just need to put your email and the license key that have been sent to you by mail. So yeah, what you need to do, you just need to select the maps. Let's say I want to generate map for this rock wall. So I don't need metallic for this. Let's press upscale factor 2x. Let's just select the image and let's wait. Here you can see that the folder is already created, and here you can see that it says maps generated. If we go inside here, you can see that we have the base color, we have the height, we have the normals, we have the roughness, and we have the ambient occlusion. If we do another one, let's generate another. Here this time, let's do this for the metal one. Let's select the metal also. Let's select this. And here you can see that the folder is already created and the maps are being generated inside. It might take a moment depending on the image that you have selected. So here you can see that map generated. Let's just quickly try them out in Blender. So I'm going to take a new material. I'm going to press Ctrl Shift T. Let's select our metal wall. So here you can see that we have a detailed texture. And you can see the roughness and everything is working fine. You can tweak it a little bit if you need. From here, if we select bump only to displacement, here you can see that we need to reduce this. So let's keep it 0.01. I think it should work. If we want, we can rotate it also. And yes. But now the thing is, there are a lot of places where you can get free texture and free materials, but this is for a particular use case that when you need your own PBR texture, like you are looking for something, but you can't find it anywhere. So what you can do is you can generate an image using ChatGPT, and by using this tool, you can convert it into a PBR texture. So let me show you a unique use case. Like suppose you have this label and you want to generate texture from it. So let's select it from here and let's wait. Here you can see that we have all the maps. So when you use this texture in your model, you can have a proper depth to it, because in terms of custom materials, you can make them inside Blender using Node, or you can purchase it from otherwhere, or there are also free resources. But this is a unique label that you need, and you can't find any resources online which have this exact material for you. So that's where my tool come in, that you can generate all the maps from any image you want, and you can have your own PBR texture. So yeah, now let's just open Blender and let's see how it looks. Let's take a new material and then press Ctrl Shift T, press A and OK. Now let's rotate it. So yes, here you can see if we just adjust it a bit. So yes, here you can see that we have our own custom PBR texture with the details that you couldn't find anywhere. And also I'm going to make a dedicated video for this tool, that how to use it and what are the unique use cases for this. But if you want to try it out, there is a link in the description. You can just directly get it from Gumroad. And yes, there is also a giveaway. The rules are really simple. You just need to subscribe, hit the like button, and there's a form in the description You just need to fill it up and comment down done. So after that, if you're among the first 15 people who have completed all of these steps, I will directly send you the tool with the license key. And there will be also a feedback from there. So if you use it and find any bugs or any issues, feel free to fill up the feedback form. And lastly, here's a video for you where I have talked about how our team was able to increase efficiency 9 times by leveraging AI. And also here's a Blender tutorial for you. I'll see you there. Ta-da.